I know a lot of the people who've been going to the Greenbelt meetings have been saying that they've been struggling with the consultation website. So we've put together a bit of a video with some of the stuff that will get you up and running. Before I get started, I just want to point out that you don't actually need to use their website if you don't want. You can send them an email or you can send them a letter. The details of how to are on the screen right now and I'll stick them up again at the end. If you do send them an email or post them a letter though, just remember to include your full name and address. If you don't, they can reject your feedback because you didn't leave enough details to identify yourself. All right, let's get back to doing the web portal. First, start up your web browser. I'm going to be using Google Chrome here, but it should be familiar enough if you're using something else. The most direct route is just to type in the website address into your browser address bar like this. So just type in http://gmsf-consult.objective.co.uk and that'll take you straight into their GMSF website. If you're watching this video on YouTube or Facebook, all the links you might need are included in the video description, so that'll save you a bit of time. Alternatively, just do a web search for GMSF. For example, this is me searching for GMSF using Google. Or, if you prefer to use another search engine like Bing, you can search like this. Alright, when you get to the search results, just look for Greater Manchester Spatial Framework, GMCA, or Greater Manchester Spatial Framework Consultation Home. Those are the two main pages you're going to want to end up on. If you end up on the Greater Manchester Combined Authority website about the GMSF, then there's a link on the right hand side that will take you direct to the consultation page. When you first get to their site, you might get a little pop up that says that they use cookies. Just click X to close it. Okay, you should be on the main website now. So the first thing you're going to need to do is register. Registering will allow you to set up a user for their portal, allowing you to write comments or give feedback. Up in the right-hand corner, there's a link for login register. You just need to click on that. A little box will appear, and since you're not already a user, just click on the register option. The next page gives you a choice as to the type of person you are registering. We're all consultees, so just hit the register as consultee button. And after that, this is where you put in the details about yourself. So you would type in your title, like Mr., Mrs., Doctor, whatever. Then there's your first name. So next is your family name, which is your surname. After that, it's your email address. It has to be a valid email address that you can access while you're registering. So perhaps don't use a work email address unless you're at work. Next thing is a username for yourself on the portal. It can be anything, but it has to be unique. It actually won't let you continue unless you've got a unique name. If you can't think of anything suitable, perhaps just use your first initial, a full stop, then your surname, and then your house number. So it could be something like c.elliot52. All right, next you need to put in your password. And they're going to make you put it in twice just to make sure you spelt it correctly. It's your password, so you can pick anything you like. Just keep in mind that websites get hacked all the time. So try not to use the same password you'd use for, say, your online banking or any other important password. A good password would be at least 10 characters long and have uppercase, lowercase, punctuation, numbers, all that sort of stuff. Maybe the GMCA have got the best security in the whole wide world, but then again, maybe they don't. Just be careful. Next, you need to click on the yes, where it says, I agree to the terms and conditions of registering. It won't let you continue unless you click yes. Finally, just click on the OK button. You'll get a confirmation screen telling you that you've been sent an email. The email will look something like this. There's a link in the middle of the email, just click on that and it'll complete your registration. That'll take you back into their website to confirm that they've activated your account. After that, it's just a case of logging in with the username and password you pick. First time you log in after registering, it'll ask you to provide a few more details about yourself. Again, you must actually include your address. The second page is about things like equal opportunities. You can skip everything on here too if you like. Once you've finished, just click on the OK button and it'll take you back to the main consultation site. Now that the website knows who you are, we can focus on how you can leave feedback. There are three main documents you might want to comment on: the consultation plan itself, the integrated assessment, and the supporting documents. My guess is that most people are going to want to comment on the plans for their area, and those are included in the top document in the list, the actual GMSF October consultation. So click on the document you're interested in, and then click on the read and comment button. As you can see, there's lots of sections and you can leave comments about any or all of them. It's up to you. If you do want to leave comments about the site in your area, then all of those are at the very bottom in section 28 called allocations. You actually want section 28.8, other allocations. As far as I know, all the Tameside ones are near the bottom. So, for example, the section for side bottom fold is in 28.8.24 and the plans for Godley Green are in section 28.8.25. For this video, I'm just going to click on one of the proposed plans at random. Alright, so now we're actually in one of the plans. Here you can read what they've got to say, all their justifications, all that sort of stuff. But mainly, you're going to want to look up in the top right-hand corner for the button that's marked Add Comments. This is where you can write all your feedback and all your comments. So, just click on that button and a window will appear which will let you put in your comments. If you have any other documents or anything else you want to attach, you can do that here too. One other thing is, the website includes a save as draft option, so you can save an unfinished comment and come back and finish it later. However, once you've finished and you're ready to send your comments to them, just click the Submit button. If you do use a Save as Draft button, then any of your unsaved comments can be viewed on your account page. Just click on the My Account and you'll see all your various comments, including all the ones you've sent in already. I didn't actually have any at this point, but I presume that you can continue to edit them here and then submit them whenever you're ready to. And once you're finished, you can just click log out. You can return to the site as many times as you like to add more comments. Just put in your username and password that you set up. And then, like the first time, just click on whichever document. And then click on the Read and Comment button. And that's pretty much it. I hope you found this video useful. Again, if you're using Facebook or YouTube, there are links in the video description to various sites and things that might be useful. And here's the reminder of the different ways you can send in your feedback. Good luck.